Hello everybody, welcome to today's video class. In today's video session, we are going to study microbes as biocontrol agents. That means how microorganisms play a crucial role as biocontrol agents. First of all, you need to know what is biocontrol. Biocontrol is a biological method is a biological method of controlling plant diseases and pests. Biocontrol is a biological method of controlling plant diseases and pests. By a method of biocontrol, we can control many plant diseases and pests. Pests means small insects which damages the crop. Now, let us enter into the topic. You might have seen that there are many insects which damages the crop. So, in order to control them, what farmer will do? He will spray certain pesticides. The farmer will spray certain pesticides on the crop to kill those insects. Because of this, there are many problems. Environment will be polluted, soil will be polluted, and those chemicals may enter into the fruits and the food products. If we eat those fruits and food products, those chemicals also enter into our body. So, use of chemical pesticides to control pests is harmful. For that purpose, biological method will be used. So that no pollution, but farmer will be succeeded in controlling the pests. A small example I will give. Let us take. You will be knowing what is biocontrol method. Let us imagine there is a crop. Many plants. There is a crop. In that crop, insect grasshopper is growing. Now, if the farmer spray chemical pesticides to kill grasshopper, grasshopper may damage the fields. No, sometimes grasshopper may damage the fields. Farmer, if he spray chemical pesticides, it is harmful. It is polluting. Now, biologically we can play a trick. We can introduce an organism which eats this grasshopper. We should introduce an organism which eats grasshopper. Now what happens if frog is introduced? Now what frog will do? Frog will eat these grasshoppers. So, your farmer, without spraying any chemicals, By using a biological organism, by using one organism, is killing another organism. That's what is called biocontrol. We are controlling the pests by using biological method. Here, to control grasshopper, we use a frog. And remember one thing, whatever the organism we are introducing now, it should control the pest, but it should not damage the crop field. In such a way, we have to see. Understood? Whatever the organism we are introducing, that should remove only the pests. They should not damage the crop field. Here you see, frog will eat the grasshopper, but it won't damage the fields. Understood? Are you clear? Now, so, indirectly, if any organism is damaging the crop, the organism which eats this particular organism must be introduced. That means, if any organism is damaging the crop, its predator should be released. Here, grasshopper is damaging the crop. To control grasshopper, the predator of grasshopper should be released. Who is the predator of grasshopper? Frog. You see, we didn't spray any chemical pesticides. We used a biological method to control grasshopper. So, this biocontrol method depends on predator-prey relationship. Okay, this biocontrol method depends on which principle? Predator and prey relationship. Why? If any organism is damaging the crop, we are introducing its predator. We are introducing its predator. That predator will kill the prey. So, biocontrol method depends on predator prey relationship. It is very important, neat point. Based on which factor biocontrol methods are dependent on? So, which principle is involved here? Predator prey relationship. That means, to control one organism in the field, we are introducing its predator. To control one organism, we are introducing the other organism without using any chemical pesticides. So, these are biocontrol methods. Now, in this class, let us discuss what are various microorganisms which can be used as biocontrol agents. Okay, let us discuss one by one. Let us discuss one by one. First, ladybirds and dragonflies. Actually, this comes under beetles. Ladybirds and dragonflies, they come under beetles. They will be having a black colored marking on their body surface. They will be having a black colored marking on their body surface. Now, these ladybirds and dragonflies, if they are introduced into the crop field, okay, ladybirds will kill aphids. Ladybirds will control aphids. Dragonflies will control mosquito larva. Now you see, aphids and mosquito larva, they will damage the crop fields. But here, to control aphids and mosquito larva, we are not spraying any chemical pesticides. Simply, we are introducing their predators. Okay, we are introducing ladybirds and dragonflies. The ladybirds and dragonflies will kill aphids and mosquitoes, mosquito larva respectively. This is one biological control method. Another best example, Bacillus thuringiensis. Bacillus thuringiensis. This Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a bacteria. Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacteria. Okay? It controls many butterfly caterpillars. It controls many butterfly caterpillars. Now, let us see what happens. Butterfly caterpillars, they will damage the crop field, especially cotton. Now, what farmers will do is, they will take this Bacillus thuringiensis in the form of dried spores, in sachets of dried spores. This Bacillus thuringiensis will be taken in sachets. Sachets means packets. Okay, packets of dry spores. Now, these spores are mixed with water. And sprayed in the field. When these were sprayed in the field, these will enter into the gut. The gut of this caterpillar larva. Gut means the, which is a part of digestive system. Okay, they enter into the gut of the caterpillar larva and they will damage the gut and this caterpillar larva will be dying. But here the problem is, this bacillus thuringiensis is effective only for particular insects. It's not effective for other insects. So by using a genetic engineering, nowadays what they are doing is, here bacillus thuringiensis dried spores are toxic. Now in this bacillus thuringiensis, to produce toxin, one gene is responsible. For every character in our body, one gene is responsible. Here, when we spray dried spores, why this caterpillar larva is getting died? Because these spores are toxic. Now, to produce this toxin, one gene is responsible. What they are doing is, directly they are introducing that gene into the plant. So that plant also has that gene, plant also releases that toxin, so the insects will die. In biotechnology chapter, we are going to study that. First, they are introducing this gene to cotton plant. That's why we call such type of cotton plant as BT cotton. BT means what? Bacillus thuringiensis. In this cotton plant, the toxic gene, from Bacillus thuringiensis was taken and introduced into this plant. We will study about it later in the further classes. So, dry spores of this Bacillus thuringiensis are mixed with water and sprayed in the field. When it was sprayed in the field, it will kill the butterfly caterpillar larvas. Okay, they are sprayed on many fruit giving trees, and they are sprayed on brassica plant like that. Okay, so this is another biocontrol agent. Next, third one, trichoderma. We studied about trichoderma in industrial products. Trichoderma is a free living fungi. Trichoderma is a free living fungi. Free living means what? Which won't cause any disease. Okay, if any organism won't cause any disease, we call it as free living. If it causes disease, we will say it as parasitic. Here, Trichoderma is a free living fungi. Okay, it is present in roots, of various plants. And this fungi is very much effective against many root-borne pathogens. Okay, it will kill many root-borne pathogens, and it acts as one of the biocontrol methods. Next, another thing, baculovirus. Okay, there are many groups of baculoviruses. But in this baculovirus, there is a specific genus called nucleopolyhedrovirus. There are many groups of baculoviruses. In the baculoviruses, there is a particular genus called nucleopolyhedrovirus. It is genus. Okay. So, nucleopolyhedrovirus, it is a genus under baculovirus. Baculovirus, there are many baculoviruses. In that, there is a particular genus called nucleopolyhedrovirus. This virus is very much effective in controlling many insects and many arthropods. It is one of the best biocontrol agent. It won't harm other organisms like fishes, mammals and all. It also won't cause harm to a plant. It won't harm the plant. It won't cause harm to other organisms like fishes, mammals and all. It is one of the best biocontrol agents. Now you observe all these examples. Here we are controlling many pests. pests, many insects, which damages the crop field by using other organisms. Here we are not using any chemical pesticides. That's why it is known as a biocontrol method. You see here, Bacillus thuringiensis is a microbe, which is used as a biocontrol agent. Trichoderma is a microbe, which is used as a biocontrol agent. Baculovirus is a microbe, which is used as a biocontrol agent. So, this is about the role of microbes as biocontrol agents. But very, very important thing, biocontrol agent depends on which principle? It depends on predator-prey relationship. Okay? That's all about microbes as biocontrol agents. This is very important for 3-mark question. In the next class, we will discuss the role of microbes as fertilizers. Okay? Thank you. Have a nice day.